Do you know that studies have revealed that around one-third of the populations in the US are introverts? Tests such as Myers-Briggs Type Indicator, MBTI, or the SAPA project can help you determine whether you're amongst the people with this personality type. Still, several signs indicate introversion. In this video, I will share with you 9 characteristics you're an introvert. 1. Being around lots of people drains your energy. Do you ever feel exhausted after spending time with a lot of people? After a day interacting with others, do you often need to retreat to a quiet place and have an extended amount of time all to yourself, like regarding yourself? One of the significant characteristics of this personality type is that introverts have to expend energy in social situations, unlike extroverts who gain strength from such interactions. That doesn't mean that all introverts avoid social events altogether. It does not mean that they are shy. Many introverts enjoy spending time around others, with one key caveat. Introverts tend to prefer the company of close friends. While an extrovert might go to a party to meet new people, an introvert tends to spend quality time talking to good friends. But introverts, as social as some may seem, still tend to find social events draining. While they manage to show face and excel at entertaining, they need lots of downtime to recharge after such events. 2. You can't stop having inner monologues. Have you ever heard of the statement, "I have more conversation in my head than I do in real life"? Well, that is a typical introvert for you. You have a distinct inner voice that's always running in the back of your mind, and it's hard to shut off. Sometimes you can't sleep at night because your mind is still going. Thoughts from your past haunt you. "I can't believe I said that stupid thing 5 years ago." You're always thinking about one thing or the other, from the critical ones to the silliest. It just feels like you're having a conversation with yourself. Marty Olsen-Lanni, author of The Introvert's Advantage, once said that extroverts don't have the same internal talking as introverts do. They prefer to express themselves without even thinking. But introverts believe, think, and overthink before saying what they have in mind. 3. You enjoy quiet. People sometimes make the mistake of thinking that just because a person is quiet, it also means the person is shy. It is essential to realize that there is a big difference between introversion and shyness. However, as an introvert, your idea of a good time is a quiet afternoon to yourself to enjoy your hobbies and interests, a few hours alone with a good book, a peaceful nature walk, or your favorite television program are great ways to help you feel recharged and energized. This does not mean that the average introvert wants to be alone all the time. Many introverts love spending time with friends and interacting with familiar people in social situations. Introverts tend to be more reserved and inward-turning. They like to get to know a person more before engaging in a lot of conversation. The critical thing to remember is that after a long day of social activity, an introvert will probably want to retreat to a quiet place to think, reflect, and recharge. Don't just assume that you are shy. You are just a reserved person. 4. You have a high level of self-awareness. Because introverts tend to be inward-turning, they also spend a great deal of time examining their own internal experiences. If you feel like you have a piece of excellent knowledge and insight into yourself, your emotions, and your feelings, you might be more of an introvert. Introverts tend to enjoy merely thinking about and examining the things in their minds. Self-awareness and self-understanding are essential to introverts, so they often devote a great deal of time to learning more about themselves. This might involve exploring hobbies they enjoy, thinking about their lives, and reading books that explore themes and topics that are important to them. If you feel that you are self-aware and enjoy gaining in-depth knowledge about yourself, then you might be more of an introvert. 5. You prefer jobs that afford you the time to work on your own. If a group project feels overwhelming or lonesome, you might be an introvert. Introverts often work best when they work alone. The isolation allows introverts to focus profoundly and produce high-quality work. Jobs that require a great deal of social interaction usually hold little appeal to people high in introversion. On the other hand, careers that involve working independently are often an excellent choice for introverts. This isn't to say introverts don't work well with others. They prefer to retreat and focus on the task at hand, rather than navigate the social aspect of working in a group setting. For example, an introvert might enjoy working as a writer, accountant, computer programmer, graphic designer, pharmacist, or artist. Generally, introverts thrive as freelancers because they love working independently and getting to use their insights. It also means you can set your schedule, control your environment, and lower your stimulation level. 6. You feel more alone when you are in a crowd than when you are alone. There's something about being with a group of people that makes you feel disconnected from yourself. Maybe it's because it's hard to hear your inner voice when there's so much noise around you. Whatever the reason, as an introvert, you crave intimate moments and deep connections, and those usually aren't found in a crowd. The idea of being home alone is more thrilling for you than hanging out. These periods of solitude are crucial to your health and happiness. Whether you're only spending time resting or engaging in an activity, isolation is a welcome relief. Introverts often enjoy reading, gardening, crafting, writing, gaming, watching movies, or doing any other action that's performed alone. 7. You have a small circle. One common misconception about introverts is that they don't like people. While introverts do not typically enjoy a great deal of socializing, they do enjoy having a small group of friends to whom they are incredibly close. Instead of having a large social circle of people they know only on a superficial level, introverts prefer to stick to deep, long-lasting relationships marked by a great deal of closeness and intimacy. Researchers have found that people high in this trait tend to have a smaller group of friends. While extroverts generally have a wide circle of friends and acquaintances, introverts typically choose their friends much more carefully. Their closest relationships tend to be profound and significant. They also prefer to interact with people on a one-on-one basis rather than in a large group setting. 8. You don't like to be the center of attraction. At work, an introvert will instead pull his or her boss aside after a meeting and have a one-on-one conversation, or email your ideas then explain them to a room full of people. The exception is when you feel passionate about something. You will risk overstimulation, which you dread when you think speaking up will genuinely make a difference. Many introverts hate being the center of attention. They don't want to have the speaker suddenly call on us in a seminar, and certainly don't want someone telling funny stories about us to a group. It's not like you are shy or cannot speak in public. You make good public speakers because your speeches are coordinated. Still, you may like to observe activities for just a bit and make preparations, instead of jumping straight in and have all eyes staring without being prepared. 9. You are observant. Introverts, especially high-sensitive introverts, can get overwhelmed by too many stimuli. But there is an upside to your sensitivity. You notice details that others might miss. For example, you might notice a subtle change in your friend's demeanor that signals that she's upset, but oddly, no one else in the room sees it. Or you might be highly tuned into color, space, and texture, making you an incredible visual artist. Although it may look like they're just sitting quietly during a meeting, introverts are soaking in the information that's being presented and thinking critically. Dr. Jennifer Kenweiler, author of The Introverted Leader, Building on Your Quiet Strength, once noted that the typical introvert also uses his or her nature to read the room. They're more likely to notice people's body language and facial expressions, which makes them better at interpersonal communication. When people hear the term introvert, you assume that it merely refers to someone who is shy or quiet and prefers to be alone. While that may be true for some introverts, there's much more to this personality type. However, whether you're an introvert or an extrovert, all depends on how you process the world around you.